How you guys doing tonight? Look like a choir right now, you don't even know. About the freedom that we have in Jesus.
Yeah.
Before we sing this one as a prayer together, as we kick off the fall, there's going to be all sorts of homework and challenges and family dynamics and sibling dynamics. And the best thing we can do first is to offer ourselves to God and say, God, I'm yours. Here's all of them.
Life, you endure, you are.
offer ourselves to you tonight. We offer ourselves to you at this place in our life, wherever that is, whether that's beginning school, going back to school, whether we just moved here, whether there's craziness already in our family with fall activities and sports. We stop and set apart this time tonight to say, here we are, God, we are yours. Speak what is true. And we know what is true, God, is that we are yours, that you define us, that the expectations, the challenges, the failures, even the successes don't define us, God, that you define us. So speak to our hearts tonight as we worship and as we hang out and as we dance and as we party. Meet us here, and we love you in Jesus' name. Awesome. I think Adam's going to come up and talk for a few minutes here. Let's hear it for Adam. Adam, 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 Adam.
So thanks to all of you who have helped make that happen. And before we go any further, I just wanted to, as our fall kickoff, hey, Mary Claire, would you go get everybody who's in the cafe and bring them in? I think we're missing a chunk of folks. Before we start, I wanted for us to all get a chance to, I know you all have played some games and you've had dinner together, but I don't know how well you know each other just yet. So if you are in sixth grade, raise your hand. Yeah, you are our sixth graders! Woo-hoo! Yes, sixth graders, my favorite. I love the sixth graders. All right, if you are in 10th grade, raise your hand, 10th grade! There's everybody coming in. Any sixth or 10th graders that we missed that are coming in? Ellie, there you are, Ellie's in sixth grade. All right, what about, let's see. 8th grade! 8th grade! Yeah! Alright. Let's see. How about freshmen? Yeah! Right. You're not in a freshman, okay. How about our 7th graders? Yes! Alright. What about our juniors? And last but not least, everybody give it up for our seniors! Yeah. All right, all right. All right, so you guys, I want to share with you real quick something that Keith just talked about, actually. It's always amazing how this stuff works out, but Keith just said something amazing, and it's right in line with what I wanted to talk with you about briefly, which is you aren't defined by a lot of things that we think define who we are, right? Whether it's our grades or our successes or our failures or how athletic we are or how smart we are, like those things, you guys, I hope that you hear Keith and I hope that you hear me and I hope that you hear others say, that's not what makes you you, all right? What makes you you is that you're a child of God, each and every one of you, regardless of all this other stuff. Like it's good to be smart, it's good to be successful, and sometimes life isn't easy, but that stuff doesn't define who you are. I hope, my hope for this year is that with this fall kickoff, that is the truth that propels us into this year, so that everything we do, whether it's Sunday night youth group, or whether it's small groups, or whether it's retreats, service days, mission trips, you know, fun outings, everything we do, we never lose sight of the fact that I'm a child of God, and none of this other stuff defines me. My failures, my successes, doesn't make me me. What makes me me is that God loves me and that I have a family here at Christ Church. So this year, we have an amazing opportunity, you guys, to be the hands and feet of Christ in our schools, in our communities, on our teams, in our friend groups, in our neighborhoods. And one big way that we do that, as you guys know, is through our mission trips, right? Every summer, we have mission trips, and we have the amazing privilege, you guys. You guys, it's a privilege, all right? It's a privilege to respond to God's call to be the hands and feet of Christ in the world. So, with that being said, I want to encourage you all to get plugged in this year. We've got Sunday night small groups. We've got, Sunday night youth groups. We've got small groups. We've got retreats coming up, you guys. So if you don't know where to plug in, if you're like, this is new to me, I don't know what to do, where do I go, what do I have to know, if you need to get plugged in, just come find me, come find another adult and say, I want to learn more about this youth group thing, and I want to get plugged in. Sound good? All right, so real quick before I turn it back over to Keith, he and his guys are doing such an amazing job for us tonight. And you guys, we can probably count on one hand how many youth groups get to do stuff like this. This is amazing. To have Keith and his guys here, to have these adults here working for you is amazing. Please don't take it for granted. Please make sure you thank the adults, that you thank Keith and his guys when they're done, and that you show them love and respect throughout the night. By listening, by not talking, and paying attention. All right? So it's a huge privilege that we have. All right, last but not least, we're gonna do mission trip stuff real quick, and we're gonna turn it over back to Keith. You guys, we got something really exciting planned for the middle school mission trip this summer, and it involves much, much needed help from our high school group. Okay, so that sounds kind of weird because it's the middle school mission trip, but I'm looking, at you middle schoolers to come out, show some support for this really awesome mission trip. And high schoolers, I need your help this summer with the middle school mission trip. You have an amazing opportunity to help the younger folks in the crowd on their mission trip this summer, all right? So middle schoolers, last year you went to Raleigh, right? All right, this year, you guys, can we flick it up on the screen? You guys are right here in Richmond, Virginia. That's right. So you guys have an amazing opportunity. You guys, you know that when we go to Raleigh or Roanoke or Washington, D.C., and we see all kinds of stuff, you guys know what I'm talking about? You see all kinds of stuff, and some of it's hard and some of it's challenging. Y'all know that same stuff exists right here in our city. Right? Do you know that almost 50% of the kids who live in Richmond live in poverty? Almost 50%, y'all. All right? So we have an amazing opportunity to go and be the hands and feet of Christ in Richmond. And so middle schoolers like this, I'm so excited for you to be able to serve the city. High schoolers, I'm going to be looking to you to help lead our middle schoolers on this mission trip. All right? So middle schoolers, get pumped. Get jazzed. We're going to be staying downtown so that it's just like our other mission trips, and then we're going to be serving our city. High schoolers, I need your help. All right, so I'm almost done. I'm talking way too much. Senior high mission trip is going to be back where I all be, where, back where I began. Yeah. So that's where I started. So high schoolers, I need your help this summer with our middle school group who's going to be serving our city. We sang that song obnoxiously the last time I was there. Everywhere we went is like our theme song. So middle schoolers get jazzed, high schoolers get jazzed. It's gonna be a great year in the garage. You guys are awesome. And guys, before I turn it back over to Keith, he's gonna do an acoustic set, which means this is a chance for you to sort of to focus and to really tune in on what's happening, guys. So make sure that you're giving Keith your attention, that you're giving God your attention in worship tonight. All right? Let's
thought, you know, so often I get to come to do these things, and I've been with you guys before, and I end up, you know, we come for one day, and then one evening we chat for like 15 minutes, and then the only other time I interact with you guys is on like Twitter and Instagram and things, you know. So what I was thinking was I could just kind of tell you a little bit about my life, you know, so you guys could maybe get to know a little bit about me too. I'm on staff at a church called Vine Church up in Northern Virginia, about 10 minutes from D.C., which is great. So if you're ever up in D.C., let's come, let's hang out, okay? You can come hang out. And I started a nonprofit. I was in Africa last year on a mission trip. And while I was there, these kids who spoke no English, all they wanted me to sing was Taylor Swift and Ed Sheeran, okay? So I sang these songs. They knew every word in English, but they didn't know how to speak English. But when it came to those songs, they knew everything. They knew all the spoken parts, all the rap parts, all the inflections, everything. And so what I realized was, man, music is, you know, people say, like, music is a universal language. That's super cheesy, right? But it's totally true, because I saw it. These kids, like, it was literally the universal language. And so what I began to do was kind of think outside the box, because I'm a worship leader at a church, so every week I'm leading worship. I come and do things like this, and we lead worship with our band, and it's a lot of fun. But then I started thinking, what if I could use music to impact the world and then kind of be the light of Jesus in a different type of places? So I started playing in coffee houses, playing cover songs in coffee houses. I started playing happy hours, and I played like at the Washington Nationals game. That was awesome. We played like two and a half hours of just cover songs. And I started writing these, it's super weird, but I started writing these parodies for sports, DC sports teams. For 106.7 The Fan, which is a radio station, and they started playing, they asked me to write these songs, and I wrote a song about Kirk Cousins and the Washington Capitals, and there's going to be another one in a couple weeks about the Nationals playoffs. It's just so weird. But what that's done is, because my heart is focused on Jesus the whole time, I get to go and sing these songs that probably, I mean, in general, don't have anything to do with Jesus, but because I am who God says I am, no matter where I am, it doesn't matter, I'm not like, okay, when I'm at church, I'm this person. When I'm at home, I'm this person. When I'm at the Nats game, I'm this person. When I'm at a coffee house, I'm this person. I'm just the same person. And so music is just a vehicle for me to have conversations with people. So that's kind of like the heart behind what I've been doing. And so, you know, I encourage you guys, as you start this fall, and as you think about, you know, what, you know, especially some of your older people, as you're going to be thinking about, what am I going to do in the world? What do I want to do? The question is really, who do I want to be? Who does God want me to be? And then what you do kind of just isn't as important as who you are, right? So I thought I could just give you a little taste of like what I do outside of church. Would that be good?
All those times that you rain on my parade, for all those clubs you get in using my name, but you broke my heart, oh girl, for goodness sake. Think I'm crying on my own, but I ain't.
Come on, sing it.
And I didn't want to write a song, cause I didn't want anyone taking. I still care, I don't, but you still hit my phone up. Maybe I'll be moving on, and I think you should be something. I don't want a whole act. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. I never liked to admit that I was wrong. I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on. But now I know I'm better sleeping on my own. Cause if you like the way you like that much, oh, maybe you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should yourself. And if you
that?
You know Love Story by Taylor Swift?
Love Story. Which one is that? I mean, it can't be hard, so.
Like green, stronger than
bad one, good, the bigger on the one, all right. Our love will keep you on the tight. Don't take money, don't take faith. Don't need no credit card, ride this train. It's strong and it's sudden, and it's cruel sometimes. And I might just save a life. That's the power of love.
Alright, that's the 80s. Okay, here's the 90s.
Let it go. You only need one shot. Now it's your chance to blow. It's how we go.
Repeat after me, goes like this. 1, 2, 3. You gotta give it up. If you wanna live it up. You gotta give it up.
Who is it is to come your name? Power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you?
Wipe the sweat off my face, get a sip of water.